Hello, everybody. Welcome to today's Sermon on the Go. Today's Sermon on the Go comes from the book of Job. Job chapter 11 from verses 17 to 18. Let's hear the reading of God's word. And your life will be brighter than the noonday. Your darkness will be like the morning. And you will have confidence because there is hope. And you will be protected and take your rest in safety. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Friends, a little bit of background into this reading. This reading is about a man in the Bible called Job. And there is a book about him called the Book of Job, just before the Book of Psalms. In Job chapter 1, you and I are treated to a conversation to which Job has no idea that that conversation is going on. Job was very rich. He had 10 children, 7 boys and 3 girls. And there was a meeting of angels in heaven. And in that meeting, Satan also came to that meeting. And when Satan appeared in that meeting, he wasn't expected. So God asked him, "What are you doing here, Satan?" Satan said to God, "Well, I'm going through and fro." Then God asked Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job?" Satan then responded, "Well, Job is like that because you have protected him. You have blessed him and you have made him rich." This is all recorded in the first chapter of the book of Job. When you have time, take a look at it. Satan is saying, "Well, Job is like that because you have blessed him. You have made him rich. His children are rich. Everything about Job is rich. But if you stretch forth your hand and take everything from Job, he will curse you to your face." Now, this is Satan talking to God. So that conversation goes on. And while this is going on, Job have no idea that this is going on about him. So when we read the Bible, we are treated to this conversation. We have privilege to read this information that the actual subject, who is Job, was not aware of. During that conversation, God allowed Satan to touch Job. He said, "Well, you can go and touch him. You can go and mess with him. But his life, you cannot touch his life." So, as it were, God permitted Satan to go and mess with Job. And if you read the book of Job, Satan did mess with Job. All his children died. All his property was destroyed. All his riches was gone. Everything that Job had was destroyed. In fact, his friends, Job's friends, were encouraging Job to denounce God, to curse God and die. And throughout all this ordeal or situation, Job was steadfast and he continued to hold on to God. It is this Job that God is speaking to in Job 11, verses 17 to 18. And God says that, "And your life will be brighter than the noonday. Your darkness will be like the morning. And you will have confidence because there is hope. You will be protected and you will take your rest in safety." Friends, brothers and sisters, I don't know what you are facing today. That whatever it is that you are facing, it wasn't as bad as Job went through. Job was very rich. It will be like the likes of Bill Gates and Richard Branson. You can name those people who are rich in our society. And in about 24 hours, all their riches disappeared. If I'm talking about Bill Gates, All his riches disappeared. Everything he holds, his properties, his children, all his children dies. Everything he has worked for went through the drain. Do you think you have the boldness and faith to continue to believe in God? You only need the grace of God. Because if the grace of God is not upon your life, when you start to go through pain, if you start going through any painful circumstances, you are in danger of renouncing God. But when you read the book of Job, towards the end of it, God blessed Job so much that he was rich, more than he was when we began reading the book of Job. So Job was rich in his latter state than in his beginning state. The Bible is saying that your life will be brighter than the noonday. Your darkness will be like the morning. You will have confidence because there is hope. You will be protected and you will take your rest in safety. Friends, brothers and sisters, in the book of Job, Job went through a very difficult time. Everything he held dear was lost. Nevertheless, he continued to serve God. He continued to worship God. He continued to believe in God. And in the end, God blessed him. The blessing he received at the end of that situation was more than the blessing he had when he began. So friends, brothers and sisters, I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what challenge you are facing. But that challenge is not more than what Job went through in the book of Job. So whatever it is that you're facing, I want you to bring it before God. I want you to continue to believe in God. If you don't believe in God, then I give you this opportunity to turn to Christ. Turn to God and believe in God, because he is the omnipotent God. He created you. He is the Alpha and Omega. He created the universe. He is the reason why you are living. So whatever it is that you are facing, if you don't believe in God, the first step is to turn to Christ. I want you to believe in God. The moment you start believing in God, God will be able to give you strength, confidence, ability to be able to go through, to get you through that situation. And at the end of it, God will bless you beyond all measure. God will bless you beyond what you can think of or imagine. Because he is the Alpha and Omega. He supplies all of our needs according to his riches and glory. Whatever it is that you are going through, God is saying that your life will be brighter than the noonday. Your darkness will be like the morning. And you will have confidence because there is hope. You will be protected and you will take your rest in safety. Brothers and sisters, you are not here on earth by accident. You were born for a purpose and for a reason. It is only God that can direct you or take you to your purpose or direct you to the reason for which you were born. I want you to seek God. I want you to begin to look for God. Come to God. Come to him with everything on your heart, every burden. Bring it to God and he will give you rest. With God in your life, everything you are hoping for, everything you are believing for, with God, those things will be possible. With God, all things that you are seeking for is possible. Job went through a lot. All his properties was taken from him. If it was today, a lot of you who are watching me, the slightest sight of trouble, pain, discomfort, you begin to curse God and you begin to renounce God. There are people out there who says that there is no God, that they don't believe in God. Brothers and sisters, I often say this, that whether you believe in God or not, whether you believe in the existence of God or not, you are a child of God. So whatever it is that you are going through, bring it before God. Every sin that you have committed, God says that He will wash away your sins and you will be as white as snow. Whatever it is that your sin looks like, God will wash that sin away. Everything that troubles your heart, bring it before God, and God will turn that hopeless situation around. God will turn that situation that seems impossible, God will turn it around. So if you don't know God, I give you the opportunity today to turn to Christ. If you believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and that He was raised from the dead, you will be saved. Bring everything on your heart to God, because your life will be brighter than the noonday. Your darkness will be like the morning. You will have confidence because there is hope. You will be protected and you will rest in safety. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. I will see you on Thursday. Shalom. Peace.